Good morning, students. In the previous video, we have studied about parliamentary form of government, federal and unitary, and universal adult franchise also we have studied. And today we will take up the topic single citizenship. So what is the meaning of single citizenship? In United States of America, there is a double citizenship. This question comes for 1 mark, okay? This line I am telling you. Every American is a citizen of her or his state and also of the United States of America. That means if you are living in Alabama, if you are living in California, you are a citizen of California, Alabama and other states also. And you are a citizen of United States of America also. Means you have 2 citizenships. But in India, we have single citizenship. So, in our country, we don't have dual, we have single citizenship. Therefore, every Indian, irrespective of the place where he, she lives, is a citizen of India. So, wherever we are living, whether we are living in Himachal, Assam, Meghalaya, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, we are not the citizens of the state, we are the citizens of a country, that is India. There is no citizenship in the name of the states. So we do not have any kind of citizenship in the name of states. All the citizens of India can secure employment anywhere in the country. So we can have employment in any place of our country. Like people used to go to Noida, Delhi, Bangalore, Mumbai. So we can do that. People who call themselves Punjabis, Marathis or Gujaratis are called so because they speak these languages, right? We Himachalis used to call us Pahadi because we are speaking this language, okay? And not on the basis of their citizenship. It has nothing to do with our citizenship. We all are Indians. But the language we speak, because of that only we call ourselves Punjabi and Gujarati, Marathi, Tamil. Okay? Now, single integrated judicial system. So, what is the meaning of that single integrated judicial system? So, India has a single integrated judicial system. You know, these words are very important, single and integrated. What is the meaning of that? Unlike the judicial system of the United States, we do not have separate federal and state courts. So, you know, hamare koi alag alag courts nahi hai ki hamare federal means union court alag hai aur state courts alag hai. In our country, the entire judiciary is one hierarchy of courts. अब वन हायरार्की ऑफ कोर्ट्स कैसे है देखो. सबसे ऊपर वी हैव सुप्रीम कोर्ट, ओके. देन वी हैव हाई कोर्ट, ठीक है. ये है नेशनल लेवल पे, ये है स्टेट लेवल पे, एंड उसके बाद हमारे पास हैं डिस्ट्रिक्ट कोर्ट्स. Fine, many courts comes here for district courts, right? So, अगर यहाँ पे हमने कोई केस फाइल किया, we are not satisfied with the hearing of that, हम हाई कोर्ट जाएंगे. हाई कोर्ट में भी हमको सेटिस्फैक्शन नहीं हुई, then we will go to सुप्रीम कोर्ट, okay? तो ये क्या है, सिंगल इंटीग्रेटेड है. ऐसा नहीं कि इनकी अपनी मर्जी चल रही है, इनकी अपनी मर्जी चल रही है, ऐसा कुछ नहीं है. Fine, they are integrated, single system hai ye, okay. The Supreme Court of India and the High Courts form a single integrated judicial structure with jurisdiction over all laws. Maine aapko bata diya ye, theek hai. The High Court have the right to supervision over the subordinate courts. Ab High Court kya karta hai, inko supervise karta hai ki ye kaam theek se ho raha hai ya nahi. Supreme Court inko supervise karega, okay. India has an independent judiciary and our judiciary is independent also. Koi neta, koi minister, no one can interfere in the judicial process. This is free from the executive एंड लेजिस्लेचर, नो वन कैन इन्फ्लुएंस इट. ठीक है. द जजेस आर अपॉइंटेड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ देयर क्वालिफिकेशंस बट दे कैन नॉट बी ईजीली रिमूव बाय द एग्जीक्यूटिव. सो ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ देयर क्वालिफिकेशन दे आर अपॉइंटेड बट उनका रिमूवल दैट इज नॉट सो ईजी. Therefore, a set of procedure is followed about which you will read in chapter 20 on judiciary. Okay, तो removal का एक procedure है that you will study afterwards. The fundamental rights, directive principles of state policy and fundamental duties. Fundamental rights we all know, हमारे constitution में दिए हैं, right to freedom, right to religion, freedom of religion, ऐसे ऐसे rights हैं बहुत सारे. सो दे आर दी बेसिक फीचर्स. ये जो है ना सारी चीज़ें, ये हमारे कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन का बेस है. ओके. देन दैट प्रिस्क्राइब द फंडामेंटल ऑब्लिगेशंस ऑफ द स्टेट टू इट्स सिटीजन एंड द ड्यूटीज ऑफ द सिटीजन्स टू द स्टेट. अब देखो, स्टेट की हमारे लिए क्या रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है और हमारी स्टेट के लिए क्या रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है. स्टेट का मतलब कोई हमारी स्टेट नहीं, स्टेट मीन्स कंट्री. वी शैल बी लर्निंग अबाउट these vital elements of the constitution in the next chapter. So about these in detail we will study in the next chapter. So students, now your chapter is completed. Okay, जो बीच में रह गया था, fine. And these keywords are important, आप पढ़ सकते हो इनको. And now we will take up the exercise portion. Tick the correct option. In a parliamentary form of government, अब इनमें से हमने देखना है, the executive is answerable to the Parliament, that is the correct option. A is the correct answer. The Constituent Assembly of India consisted of, जिन्होंने constitution बनाया, they were consisted of indirectly elected members. B is the correct answer. Most of the provisions of Indian constitution can be amended by, the answer is special majority, that is B. Freedom of religion makes India a secular state. The answer is C. Which one of the following statements goes against the spirit of federalism in India? Means जो federalism को justify नहीं कर रही है. Okay, federalism को, that is the government at the center is very strong. Okay, now we have fill in the blanks. Dash is the basic unit of society. Family is the basic unit of society. India is a vast country which with various physical, cultural and social diversities. Then the constitution provides a set of rules, principles and laws acceptable to all, almost all. You must remember the spelling of principle. Okay. England is not a republic because its head of the state is queen or king. India has a single dash judicial system, single integrated. Now only we have studied. Now we have true and false. Mohan is a Gujarati but lives in Himachal Pradesh and has a dual citizenship. So is it possible? Hai? No. So this statement is false. The President of India has the power to remove any judge of the Supreme Court. This is also false because we have a proper procedure for the removal of judges. That is not an easy task. There were 15 female members in the Constituent Assembly of India. Yes, that is true. The constitution is called rigid or flexible on the basis of the procedure for its amendments. Yes, it is true. India is a sovereign and socialist state but not secular. It is false. We are a secular state also. So students, up to here only we will study today. And in the next video, we will take up these question answers. I am not going to upload them in the website because they are also the easy ones. So we will discuss them in the video. If some question, any question will be difficult enough, then I will upload that. Thank you students. Have a nice day. Till then, revise the chapter thoroughly and complete your exercise work in your book. Thank you, students. Have a nice day.